Yo, peeps. Yeah, I'm just at London Palladium right now. Going to go and watch. What's it called? High Performance Live, the podcast. Going to go watch it now. See what they say. The video, bro. Look at his. Look at his.
That man has got paper scissors.
That's it. Hold it now.
Get me.
Oh shit, recorded!
Oh man! Hey, don't block the way, bro.
Oh yeah, man, match of the day, innit?
Man's back in London Palladium. The time I come here, we rented this venue up. Done the comedy show, man. Sick. In London Palladium, though, but yeah, I'm not gonna lie, they're treating man a bit funny, you know. Treating man a bit funny, fam. Man's asking a guy if there's food being sold. He's telling me, talking about if I've got tickets. But why the hell would I be here, fam? Acting up still. London Palladium, you lot still ain't changed.
I feel like this place was bigger.
Reckon?
When I went from the last, I felt like it was bigger.
Ian Brown of the Stone Roses has said, it's not where you're from, it's where your ally is unique, they're incredible, and they're powerful as well.
So what have our journeys been like to this point? Well, I'm going to rewind the clock to 1978. Peterborough, and the middle son of Rex and Liz Humphrey was born.
Because they have the resilience to keep on going. Here's another one, Amelia Earhart. Someone I think is incredible. It's also my daughter's hero. You love her, don't you, Florence? Yeah? Has she left already? Are you here, Flo? No, she's not.
Just the last, it's a real privilege. So, I know that when we were talking about this, you come from the Eggsley part of Stockholm.
So, 5 years ago, my life looked entirely different to how it does right now. Essentially, you can't get to where you want to go until you know where it is you are headed. And I think at this very first step, we often get so stuck because we're so limited by our own insecurities. We don't actually allow ourselves to even dream about what we want. So if I said to all of you now, okay, I want you to think of a number that you could earn in the next year. Think of how much money you want to earn in the next year. 90% of you will think of a number that you think is realistic. So the very first step, you're not even allowing yourself the opportunity to see the things that you want. So being clear in your vision is about having enough courage and bravery and vulnerability.
Manifesting and stuff. How do you stay resilient when money is so tight? We have so many people in the media now that do it this way. I was broke, I was here. You know, that's great. But for people, entrepreneurs like me, who run two different companies, have my son here trying to inspire him and be a role model. But when money is tight and tight, and you just think, well, if this lady here gave me 100 grand or 50 grand or 10 grand, you know, I could put this into, I know what to do with the money. So when money is tight, how do you stay with your stick forward, as Amelia Earhart would say?
Yeah, listen, we're well aware of that. Like, we're all, everyone, in a cost of living crisis at the moment. I think that.
Bring your feet.
Take away, please.
Hey guys, now give your feedback.
Bro,
what's good? Give your feedback. Pierre.
Three out of five.
Three out of five.
As well. It's a bit underwhelming.
A bit what?
A bit underwhelming. They could have had more guests there.
Yeah.
More guests from the podcast. You know what I'm saying? A lot of the stuff that was there. Yeah. Me personally, I don't know. I'm speaking from my experience.
Yeah.
I knew already. I've already been living like that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Not really new
advice.
You know what I mean? Pardon?
Not any new advice.
Not new advice for me personally, innit? But yeah. I mean, someone else could think differently, but.
Alright, what are you saying, Pete?
I'll say about a 3 out of 5, man. It was alright, but. I don't know, it was a bit. I've heard it before.
That's what I say.
It almost felt like. It's like basics. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, maybe. Yeah, I don't know, it's like basics. Heard it before. But, yeah.
Rose, what are you saying?
You man did well, I'll give it a 3 out of 10.
3 out of 10?
I'll be honest, yeah. It's underwhelming. Yeah. And I'm not going to lie, like, the things they're talking about, we live that every day.
It's some soft life thing they're talking about, bro. Yeah. Soft life, soft life.
Soft. I'm not going to lie.
Soft.
I'm only a 3 out of 10.
Yeah, no. I salute that score still. Makes sense. He said, 9 out of 10, Pierre. 9 out of 10.
Out of 10, no. If I'm doing it, I don't know, it depends on who this is going to, but if it's like, I don't know, I don't want to be too harsh on it, but...
I'll say it how it is, man.
If I'm being honest, and for what I'm paying, and like, obviously I've been watching the podcast, I'm not going to lie, for me, that's going to be a 4 out of 10.
4 out of 10. Yeah, it's below average.
Didn't walk away with, like, anything new. Does that make sense? It's almost like... Without reading any motivation books, that's like you know already.
That's like first.
I'm disappointed because the podcast actually looks good.
Wait. Go on, what are you saying, man?
The big one, yeah?
You said the podcast what?
The podcast actually quite good. It's a good insight to how to be successful. It gives you insight to like successful people in their journey and different parts of it.
Yeah.
But I feel like today, potentially quite a few corners were cut.
Yes.
And the guy that sang, I think he sang twice.
Yeah.
And two women. And I thought a lot of the things they were saying,
it's beyond basic,
but it's just like basics, you know? Like,
yeah, man. I think there was no seasoning in the show, man. There was no seasoning in the show at all. I think Will's got it spot on, you know.
100%.
Spot on, bruv. I think I give it a 3 out of 10 as well, bruv. 3 out of 10. It was below average.
But
the cut corners,
there
was no...
At the same time, it could be for someone, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
No, that's what I'm saying.
I'm speaking for your... As a black man, I'm speaking for my experiences, growing up where I grew up,
it's just basic.
I'm more resilient.
Yeah,
a lot of the stuff is everyday life I'm living, you know. Yeah, so but it might be for someone else, innit?
I hear you. It could be for someone, but yeah, it's not for man still.
But on a positive note, I'm gonna go out. I'm going to go back home, we start reading some books, some motivational books, and we get back on it, yeah?
Yeah.
It's another day, another new chapter. Let's go.
Yo, I'm just in bed, after coming back from the High Performance Podcast, and it just dawned on me, like, them men have lived some... First of all, them man, the problems and stuff they was talking about, discussing about life and business and stuff here that they've had to overcome. Bruv, them problems are some champagne problems, fam. I don't know if you've ever heard the expression champagne problems. Them man are dealing with some champagne problems, fam. Them man have lived some super soft life. You know when people say soft life? Them man have lived some soft, super soft life. Like, super soft, privileged life. Like... I don't even know how to explain the bubble that I just entered and come out of. I was thinking to myself, if I ever went on that stage and told my story about stuff, how a man's grown up and was happy and stuff like that, I think people would have had a heart attack in there. Like, it was such a surreal moment. I'm like, it was even a struggle getting into the London Palladium. When I got there, something I didn't mention when I was on earlier videos, when I got there, I asked one of the guys on the door if there was food inside, like hot food, they sold anything apart from snacks or whatever. He didn't even answer the question. He kind of shunned me off and was like, you got to have a ticket to get in there anyway. I was like, bruv, what do you mean I got to have a ticket? First of all, I have got a ticket and I'm answering your question. Who are you talking to like that? He's like, what? Sorry, mate, I don't understand your language. I said, brother, you're right. I had to literally, he was on a step higher than me. Had to literally step on a step the same level as him so I could show him I'm a bigger man for him in size, in every way. And when I've squared him off, he's kind of come back in his place. And then other security came like, raw. And I said, bro, who are you talking to? Like, mine are you talking to? And I didn't want to have to be that black guy, typical, aggressive, whatever. But I had to put him in his place because I'm like, I've got a ticket. I'm not coming in yet. I'm just asking you a quick question. If there is food in there, I'll come in here. If there isn't, I'm going to get food before I come in. Then he's like, oh, no, no, no. The other guy's like, no, no, no. There's food, something, something. And I said, like, what kind of behavior is this? And then when we've come back now, they're moving like, some other guys are moving like, what are you guys doing here kind of thing? Like, because there was like 3,000 people going into this High Performance Podcast year. And probably there was like 30 out of 3,000, 30 black people. So 1% black. So obviously we've, and the other black people that was there, they were kind of older. So we've kind of been the younger black people that's come in. I had a hat on and a long Raymac with a hood. But the way they try to move, like to say, man, don't belong to something. I had to look at the brother in his eyes and be like, are you right? Anyway, them man in there obviously are talking about life and struggle. So I'm thinking to myself, bruv, you man have got some champagne problems. Like the colour of my skin, it made me realise man's life compared to, especially if you got the skin colour, yeah, life in comparison to a lot of other people was different. The questions and stuff people was asking in there, I'm like, you lot are like in your 60s, 50s, you've never faced these problems yet. You're only facing it now in your life. Or you, like, I'm thinking, what kind of easy life have you had, fam? Like, there was also some question about business, yeah? And saying if they've had any trials or tribulations. Like, my man's basic answer was like, they're all best friends kind of thing. I'm like, I wish I had that set up. The amount of people that I've done business with that have been social sighted, snaky, greedy, conniving, whatever. I'm like, if I ever told them my business stories, yeah, maybe it's me. Maybe I'm in the wrong circles in life and I need to be in their circles, but whether I get accepted or not is a different thing. But yeah, man, that High Performance Podcast, first of all, I feel like they cut so many corners. The production was whack. They didn't invest hardly any money into it. I'm sorry I'm being so blunt with this, but I have to call a spade a spade. And I thought it was just like I ate some unseasoned chicken when I went there. There was no vibe. It was just flat. It was just kind of boring, bruv. The advice they was giving is the kind of advice you can just get from not even your auntie, because you could probably get it from your five-year-old niece or nephew or brother or sister or kid. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, man, I'm like, I had high hopes for this podcast show at London Palladium, High Performance, but yeah, it was shockingly not good. Like, I wouldn't recommend it to anyone else to go to it. Like, I heard Stephen Bartlett's one was all right, a little bit better than that one. It was just more singing and dancing, apparently, but yeah, man. There was no vibe, man. And then, man, I don't know. Today was just a big reality check to make me understand people have lived some mad, privileged, soft life out here. Like, yeah. Flipping out.